I hope you enjoyed the consumer behavior session. I did, and welcome back in the lobby. Well, we are almost ready with this digital event on sustainable palm oil. We have one last session in which we look to the future of all the three organizations who organized this event. So RSPO, IDH and APOA. I am now giving Connie again the word so she can wrap up with the three organizations.
Wonderful, and thank you. And whilst you might not have seen me walk in, you certainly hear me now. It's here, a physical environment, so we actually have to walk from one studio to the other, just as an explanation. But I have all the three, the different organizations that are behind this dialogue here. And let's kick off with Marco from EPOA. So Marco, please come in. Socially distanced,
exactly. Of course.
We've had, it was just like swimming in chocolate, to use in intellectual chocolate, in sustainable free palm oil chocolate, if you forgive me. So each and every one of you comes, of course, with a slightly different perspective, whilst you all sort of agree on the ultimate goal to get 100% deforestation free and sustainable palm oil into the EU. So what was your takeaway today?
Well, I think, first of all, I would like to say that this conference is probably has the best conference ever, that some of my colleagues remarked it, and I thought it was really, really hilarious, and I think I agree. What I remarked really is that we are 87% of sustainable palm oil for food, feed and oleochemicals in Europe, which is an extremely good number. And I also feel it's amazing that so many stakeholders agreed on regulatory measures to reduce the impacts on forests in Europe. So I think we can make a big step there. But do we stop here at 86%? Do we stop at the import at Europe? I think we should go for it. We should go for 100%. Give credit to the farmers that actually make this happen. To continue our cooperation with the producers that are actually enabling us and helping us to protect the forests. And the legal measures can help, but they should be non-discriminatory, because otherwise we will shift the problem to other regions, other sectors. We will use more land, as Olivier explained nicely in the previous session. We will shift to put pressure on other types of biodiversity, and we will negatively impact the communities that are actually making it happen, that are helping us to protect the forests on the ground.
Thank you so very much. We're going to see you again in a moment. And I'd like to ask Inke from RSPO to sort of come a bit closer to me. Yes, you found your right position there. We've just come out of the consumer session. And of course, there was a lot of debate that, yes, there was a lot of communication on palm oil in the last couple of years. The only problem is some of that sort of ended up in a negative way, influencing consumers. That was one of the aspects that struck me as almost sad, because now you have to work. What is your takeaway today from the whole 150 minutes that we've had up to now?
Well, that was actually what I wanted to talk about. For me, it stood out that we're moving from a time where we see negative perception and negative communication on palm oil, and slowly we're moving into this space where we talk positively about palm oil. And I think it's really important, and it's all of our responsibility in this virtual gathering, to start communicating about palm oil in a positive manner. Educate the consumers that there is a way to produce this crop in a sustainable way, and show the positive campaign. So I feel inspired, and I hope our stakeholders are inspired by Tesco, Upfield and Ferrero showing the way in starting that space where they talk positively about palm oil. The consumer may now think that a boycott is the solution. And we have to tell them that that is not the solution. It's actually making things worse. We have to tell them that there are many efforts of this sector to make it more sustainable. So I hope our stakeholders are inspired to start highlighting the positive initiatives of the sector.
Thank you very much. And of course, we're going to do a second round where we look into the future. And with that, I say thank you to you and ask Nienke to come closer to me from IDH. We've heard a lot of new inputs today, maybe for somebody as an insider, just sort of gradually more. But maybe were there one or two aspects that even surprised you?
Yes, actually they did, thanks. So what surprised me was how in every session, it seemed to come back how we need a holistic approach to really make a viable impact on the ground, to really work together with stakeholders on the market and especially with all of the stakeholders in the producing areas, which is what a landscape approach does, right? It complements certification in working towards this viable impact on the ground. And in our experience, in the IDH experience, the local government here has a key role to play, right? Building trust between local stakeholders and external stakeholders, it takes time. It's an important process, as is building trust between producing countries and consuming countries, which is something that the NISCOPS program, for instance, enables. So it's something that I work on a lot and that we are very much engaged in. But still, I was surprised to see how much it came back in all of the sessions today.
Yes, and of course, what we also saw that you had valuable contributions, ladies and gentlemen, in the chat, which we have promised to answer all of them in the coming weeks. So don't despair if your question didn't get mirrored in either the breakout sessions or in the panel sessions. And with that, again, Macho, looking towards the future, join me, please. You have to come a tad closer. We're still sort of 1.5 meters away. I mean, with the debate about COVID-19, you can actually see how things are shifting. And what I perceive is that in your area of interest, perceptions are shifting, that people are looking at things in a different manner with new experiences. And one of the things that I heard, no silver bullet, multi-stakeholder, multifaceted approach. So we need everybody. We cannot just sort of, you know, turn one screw and think we've done it all. So that leaves a lot of work for the future. Where are you going to concentrate on?
So thank you. We actually believe in cooperation. I think that can be made clear also from today, organizing the conference spot with our partners, IDH and RSPO, but also with the Sustainable Palm Oil Choice Initiatives, where we work together with food manufacturers, producers, refiners, the conservationists, the civil society organizations. It is currently led by Marike Leegwater from Solidaridad, and I hope there will be, after this conference, more people and more organizations that will join us and be constructive partners to the initiative. For our sake, from our perspective, we will continue to watch the process, the regulatory process, carefully and provide our input wherever we can, wherever it's needed. But we will also focus on more active communication. So on the one hand, to be more out there on social media especially, but also to address negative discriminatory claims, because we see that this is hampering actually the move to 100% sustainable palm oil. And to close, in the end, I think we all want the same. We want a more and a better, more sustainable future for us, but especially also for our kids. And I think sustainable palm oil can play a really big role in that. So I would say act now, all together, and make it happen and show the world that it can be done. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Macho and Nienke. Please join me again. And IDH, of course, has the sleeves rolled up and is gearing to go for the next couple of years. Priority areas?
Yes, definitely. We do. So the other week we had a call with colleagues that are working on palm oil, and we have more than 30 colleagues at the moment that are somehow linked to palm oil, so a lot is going to happen. Traditionally, on the market side, we have done a lot of work in Europe, and last year we also started working in India, where we convene stakeholders, we monitor uptake, and work on policy very much like we do in Europe. And starting from 2021, we will be able to start in another very exciting market, namely in China. So all of the work that we do on the market side, we link to the production landscapes, right? So we link it to what we're doing in Indonesia, in Malaysia, in Colombia, and in Nigeria. And in Colombia, we just signed a 1.2 million MOU with Ferpalma and Senipalma to reach 1,500 producers, more than 80% of which are smallholders. And similarly, in our work in Malaysia and in Nigeria, it's completely geared toward the smallholder producers. And in Indonesia, we'll be continuing in the five provinces that we're already working in, whereby I would especially like to point out the work on the verified sourcing area readiness pilots that's going on in Aceh and soon also in Kalimantan. So to scale up the investments that we're doing in these landscape areas, IDH also supports blended finance funds and the related technical assistance facilities. So relating to palm oil, there was in June the news that a $30 million loan had been guaranteed to PTDSNG, who have a lot of their concessions in East Kalimantan. And more of this is to come. And to also increase investment in the production areas themselves and to enable more efficient sourcing, also the work on the verified sourcing area concept will continue and be scaled up. And lastly, in Brussels, we will be continuing to promote legislation that actually makes a positive impact on the ground, so we can all move towards the goal that we all have.
Fantastic. Thank you so much. And as I said to the ladies and gentlemen in our last round, keep up the good work, keep up the energy. But looking at you, you will do that definitely.
Thank you
very much. And with that, Inka, again, RSPO, of course, gearing to continue working on the challenges that are out there, that are shifting slightly. But if we have learned anything as a global population from C9, is that we are actually next door to our neighbors in Asia, in Africa, in South America. So what's your take? Where are the next steps?
There's a lot to discuss, and I'm happy that today everything falls together. I think one of the efforts that RSPO has been working on is increasing the communication towards consumers. So we have digital materials on different social channels to ensure that the consumers understand what this sector is improving to make it sustainable. But also we give the tools to the consumers to then engage with the manufacturers of the products that they know and love to encourage them to step up efforts and source sustainable palm oil. So it's very important to educate not just consumers, the society about the work that the sector is doing. We have to debunk palm oil myths, which is probably one of the more challenging tasks, but we will attempt to do that. Also, we have to showcase what our NGO members and Zoom members are doing to improve and work on the ground to improve practices and share credible research for the ones that are interested in the factual data. At the same time, we will be promoting the RSPO trademark app. It's all really new work for us, but we feel that this is the right time to start communicating in a positive way to consumers. We currently have an RSPO app. We're retiring this, and with the support of our members, we develop a new app. And the rollout will be in France first. As you've learned in other sessions, this is a sensitive market. So we start with the app in France, then go to the UK. So the app works as follows. You scan as a consumer the barcode in the store. You can see whether there is palm oil in the product and whether the manufacturer uses sustainable palm oil. And the data behind that app is ACOP data. So that is the annual communication of progress reports that our members submit to us. So if this rollout in these two countries is successful, we are looking for partners to roll it out globally and start more of these campaigns. One other final point, because I see we run out of time. is the shared responsibility principles. So our members have adopted the shared responsibility principles already last year, and now we have to start implementing this. So it means that all stakeholders, apart from the growers, need to invest as much in making this sector sustainable as the growers. That's the shared responsibility. So the market needs to increase the purchase of certified sustainable palm oil and need to support smallholders. Together we can create change and make an impact.
I'm very sure that you will, and looking at, and don't worry, ladies and gentlemen, behind all these organizations are also gentlemen. So whilst we have an absolute fantastic gender balance here, yes, men are also working on the same issues, just to have said it once. But this was definitely a question of women power, certainly in front of the camera. We hope that you, ladies and gentlemen, did enjoy it. Might have been challenging at times to walk with us from one digital room into the next. And if you have friends that haven't watched this event, but if you think that they should actually watch bits and pieces of it, on each of the home pages of each of the convening organizations, you will find links to bits and pieces on the internet, on YouTube, at least from next week onwards, because of course we need a little bit of editing time to do all that. And as I am signing off and wishing you all, whatever walk of life, work or country you come from, that you keep up the energy, because otherwise you wouldn't be on this dialogue, I would just like to ask, as for the last time, for Yolanda, the lady of the lobby, the one who has been the guiding force behind it all, and for the next 40 minutes people can actually still communicate here on the platform as you did when you onboarded. Yolanda, it's all yours. Thank you very much for your attention.
Yes, indeed, you can stay at this platform for another 40 minutes. We close at 1. So please click on the different buttons, click on resources where you can find our positions about deforestation. You can chat with other attendees. You can make appointments with other persons. So please stay a while on the platform if you have the time and the opportunity. And well, from this place, I would like to thank you for joining this digital event. It was a lovely experience, and I hope you liked it too.